the thin wires that we load into these experiments to actually turn into the plasma are pencil leads that you put in your refillable mechanical pencil. I'm Thomas Varnish. I'm a third year graduate student in the Puffin group here at MIT, working on the Puffin pulse power machine and lab astrophysics in general. We've been building Puffin for the past few years, and it is a new type of pulse power machine that gives us longer pulse times compared to previous experiments. In the vacuum chamber, this is where our experiment sits. And for my experiments studying magnetic reconnection and studying the process that drives solar flares, we used tiny graphite rods, or the refillable pencil leads that you find in mechanical pencils. So we passed the really intense current, about a megaamp, a million amps, through these graphite leads. And as it goes through, they heat up, a bit like a filament light bulb that glows when you pass a current through, except these glow and they heat up so much that the solid graphite turns into a plasma. We want to look at what happens when oppositely directed magnetic fields collide. And in the process called magnetic reconnection, these magnetic fields explosively break apart, they're reconfigured and flung outwards in different shapes. Magnetic reconnection is the process that drives the formation of solar flares. And solar flares are these explosions of magnetic energy on the surface of the sun, which carry with them plasma from the sun outwards into the solar system. When solar flares hit the Earth, or they're directed towards the Earth, we can end up with power outages or satellite failures. And so predicting when these will happen is really important to life on Earth. Predictions currently are unable to quite match the timescales at which solar flares are produced on the surface of the sun. So understanding the physics behind the mechanism of how they form is really important in updating these models and getting much better predictions. So magnetic reconnection also occurs inside of tokamaks. And so understanding how magnetic reconnection occurs in these plasmas and how it might disrupt fusion reactors is also important. Puffin is currently under construction and is nearing completion soon. And having a device such as Puffin here on campus at MIT will enable students to get really hands-on with developing hardware for these machines, developing diagnostics, doing experiments, and getting hands-on experience in the lab.